Welcome to Mother Velankanni English School and Junior College. Myself Bhakti Pandey. We were on the first topic of English, an astrologer's day. So we completed half of the story in part 1. So let's continue the story in part 2. In the part 1, we stopped where the astrologer and Guru Nayak agreed on the agreement here. Of 8 anas or double of it, okay? Astrologer asked for 8 anas and Guru Nayak said, okay, I agree, but you'll have to return twice of it if you're wrong, okay? After this, what happens next is, astrologer sends a prayer to heaven as the other lit a cheroot. Now what he does, as the astrologer is a fake astrologer, but now he has to prove that yes, he is having knowledge. What he does, start doing the prayer and all, his routine style, his actual style, what he used to do every day, and start pretending to pray. As the other, means Guru Nayak, lit a cheroot. Cheroot means what? Cigar, okay? Sort of cigarette or cigar. Lit a cheroot means he lights up the cheroot. The astrologer caught a glimpse of his face by the match light. Now what happens? Till now, because it is dark, astrologer is not knowing actually who is the person. What happens? Because of the litting of the cigar, because of that light, astrologer is able to see the face of the former person, of the customer, that is Guru Nayak. Glimpse means saw face of Guru Nayak. There was a pause as cars hooted on the road. Jutka drivers swore at their horses. And the babble of the crowd agitated the semi-darkness of the park. Now what? This is the situation. Sab kuch ruk gaya jaise ki. So this is the situation. It had a pause. As soon as astrologer saw the face of Guru Nayak, he was shocked. The other sat down, sucking his cheroot, puffing out, sat there ruthlessly. Means what? He sat down. He was taking his cigar, okay, in a very angry mood. Because he wanted to prove it that yes, he's a fake astrologer. And he was in a very angry mood. The astrologer felt very uncomfortable. Now the astrologer knows that he's very angry. So he started feeling uncomfortable also because he saw his face. Why? Here you'll come to know the suspense thing. What is the twist now? Here, take your Anna back. I'm not used to such challenges. It is late for me today. Now, because the astrologer is feeling very much uncomfortable, now he wants to go from there. He is just returning that Anna. He doesn't want to earn from him. He just want to return the Anna back and just want to leave from there as soon as possible. He says, it is late for me today. He made preparations to bundle up. Bundle up means wind up his things, take up his things and go or leave from there. The other held his wrist and said, held his wrist means he holded his hand. Guru Nayak holded astrologer's hand and stopped him and said, you can't get out of it now. You dragged me in while I was passing. Means now he is not letting astrologer go from there. He wants the answer now. So he will not let him go. The astrologer shivered in his grip and his voice shook and became faint. Means what? His voice started decreasing low and low. He shivered, means he feared. Leave me today. I will speak to you tomorrow. Now, anyhow, astrologer wanted to leave from there. So he is just giving a bahana sort of thing that I will speak to you tomorrow. The other thrust his palm in his face and said, challenge is challenge. Go on. The astrologer proceeded with his throat drying up. Now, gala sukte ja raha tha, throat drying up. Now he starts telling. In a very fierce state, now he starts telling, there is a woman. Stop, said the other. I don't want all that. Shall I succeed in my present search or not? Now he doesn't want to know all such crap, okay? He just wants his proper answer. For what he had come, he wants to know, will he succeed in his present search? He has come to search some person. So he is asking, will I succeed in that? Answer this and then go. Otherwise, I will not let you go till you disgorge all your coins. Means what? Disgorge means hand over. Okay? Give it. So he is now giving a sort of dhamki that I'll not let you go till you disgorge all your coins. The astrologer muttered a few incantations and replied, all right, I will speak, but will you give me a rupee if what I say is convincing? Means what? Now astrologer is telling, okay, I'll give you answers, but you'll have to give me a rupee, not 8 anas. You'll have to give me a rupee if I whatever I say is convincing, okay? Otherwise, I will not open my mouth and you may do what you like. Now, he is also in a very different mood. He is telling, if you give me 1 rupee, I'll answer. Otherwise, you do whatever you want to do. I'll not answer. After a good deal of haggling, the other agreed. Haggling means bargaining. Okay? Both of them agreed. The astrologer said, you were left for dead. Am I right? Now, here the astrologer starts something very different. You were left for dead, am I right? Means he's telling you were about to die. Am I right or wrong? So Guru Nayak says, tell me more. Means yes, that is correct. Okay, tell me more. A knife has passed through you once, said the astrologer. Knife has passed through you once means someone tried to kill him with knife. Good fellow. He bared his chest to show the scar. Means what? Now he is agreeing, yes, this had happened. He opened up his shirt or whatever he was wearing. He showed his chest and showed the scar. Scar means the mark where he had been hit by the knife. What else? Now he wants to know more. What else? And then you were pushed into a well nearby in the field. You were left for dead. Means after hitting him with the knife, trying to kill him, he was pushed into what? Into a well nearby in the field. You were left for dead. I should have been dead if some passerby had not chanced to peep into the well. Means now Guru Nayak is telling, yes, I was being pushed into the well, but I would have dead if some passerby had not be chanced to peep into the, means someone who was passing by through the field or through the well had actually peeped into the well and he came to know and he helped him out to come out, exclaimed the other, overwhelmed by enthusiasm. Overwhelmed means excited to know. Now he wants to know because he came to know that yes, astrologer is giving all the correct answers, but how? So he is very excited to know more things. When shall I get at him? He asked, clenching his fist. Means what? Now he, because he wants to get that person, he wants to actually kill that person who tried to kill him long back. So he wants to know, when will he get at him? When will he meet him? Clenching at his fist means angrily, ready to fight. In the next world, answered the astrologer, means agle janam. Okay. In the next world, answered the astrologer, he died 4 months ago in a far off town. Now astrologer is telling the person who tried to kill you, is actually dead. He died 4 months ago in a far off town. You'll never see any more of him. You'll not get to see him again. The other groaned on hearing it. Groan means what? He felt a little sad after hearing this. Why sad? Because now he won't get to take the revenge. The astrologer proceeded, Guru Nayak, you know my name, said Guru Nayak. How? The astrologer said, Guru Nayak. He astrologer directly took his name. So Guru Nayak was actually astonished by hearing, you know my name, the other said, taken aback. As I know all other things, Guru Nayak, listen carefully to what I have to say. Astrologer is telling this, okay? Your village is 2 days journey due north of this town. Take the next train and be gone. Now, your astrologer is telling Guru Nayak to just leave from there, okay? Take the train and go to your village. So here astrologer says, now go from here, take the next train and go. I see once again great danger to your life if you go from home. Means what? If you stay over here, I see more danger in your life. Now he is just trying to predict it, okay? He took out a pinch of sacred ash and held it to him. Sacred ash, as I said you. He took out the pinch of sacred ash and held it to him. He gave it to him, okay? Rub it on your forehead and go home. He is telling it to rub it on forehead and go from there. Never travel southward again and you will live to be 100. Means now astrologer is telling Guru Nayak, you go home, do not come back again and you will live 100 years more. Okay? Because there is danger for you over here. Why should I leave home again? Guru Nayak is asking. The other said reflectively, means seriously. Reflectively means seriously, he asked, why should I leave home again? I was only going away now and then to look for him and to choke out his life if I met him. Means he was very angry. He wanted to kill that person actually. He shook his head regretfully. Why regretfully? Because now he won't be able to kill that person because he's already dead, as said by astrologer. He has escaped my hands. Means somehow I couldn't do anything. I hope at least he died as he deserved. Now what Guru Nayak wants? He wants that he might have got some very cruel sort of death. Yes, said the astrologer. Now astrologer is telling, yes, he was crushed under a lorry. The other looked gratified to hear it. Gratified means very happy. Guru Nayak was very happy to hear that he got such a very cruel sort of death by coming under a lorry. The place was deserted by the time the astrologer picked up his articles and put them into his bag. Deserted means there was nothing. Everything was just shut down, a darkness. The green shaft was also gone, leaving the place in darkness and silence. The stranger had gone off into the night after giving the astrologer a handful of coins. What happened? Guru Nayak gave a handful of coins to astrologer and went off from there. It was nearly midnight when the astrologer reached home. It was very late. It was very late than the actual time astrologer used to reach home. His wife was waiting for him at the door and demanded an explanation. Of course, every day the timing was different, and that day astrologer reached very late, because of which wife was actually waiting for him at the door. And she asked, "Why are you late?" He flung the coins at her and said, "Count them." One man gave all that. Flung the coins means threw away that coins at her and said, "Count them." One man gave all that. She counted. 12.5 anas, she said, counting. She was overjoyed. Now she was very happy because this was actually what he earned, more than what he earned every day. Okay, I can buy some jaggery and coconut tomorrow. Jaggery means a sweet which is prepared from sugarcane. Okay, it is mainly used to make sweets and all. We all must be knowing good, right? So the child has been asking for sweets for so many days now. I will prepare some nice stuff for her. They have a daughter. Okay. The wife is telling that I will prepare some sweets for the daughter because she is asking for it since many days. The swine has cheated me. He promised me a rupee. As we know, before this, Guru Nayak had promised for a rupee. After 8 anas, he promised, they agreed for rupee. Astrologer asked for a rupee if he gives proper answer. So Guru Nayak had agreed. But what he gave only 12.5 anas. So he is calling him swine. Swine means pig. It is sort of an abusive word. Okay. He cheated me. He promised me for a rupee, said the astrologer. She looked up at him. You look worried. What is wrong? Now, wife has come to know that something is wrong. Why is he behaving like this? So she asked, what is wrong? Astrologer says nothing. After dinner, sitting on the pyol. Pyol means what? A string cot. Khatiya, we can say. A cot. Okay. He told her, do you know a great load is gone from me today? Now he's discussing it, whatever had happened, okay? I thought I had the blood of a man on my hands all these years. Here comes the main answer, the main suspense gets opened over here. Do you know a great load is gone from me today? I thought I had the blood of a man on my hands all these years. That was the reason why I ran away from home, settled here and married you. He's alive. Means what? Guru Nayak was searching the astrologer only. The astrologer was the only person. He was the person who tried to kill Guru Nayak. Okay. So now he is actually regretting it. But still, he has come to know. He is happy that he is alive. She gasped. Gasped means what? She is astonished. She is shocked to know this. You tried to kill him? Yes, in our village, when I was a silly youngster, means when astrologer was young, before leaving the village, in his village, he says, we drank, gambled and quarreled badly one day. Gambled means playing cards and all with money. Quarreled, they had a fight badly one day. Why think of it now? Time to sleep, he said. Now he wants to just forget it because he knows that the person is alive. So a big load has gone now because of which the circumstance because of which astrologer had left the village. Now the load has gone. He knows that he is alive. So now he says, time to sleep, he said, yawning, and stretched himself on the pyol. Means he was about to sleep now. Okay. So students, how did you find the story? I hope you enjoyed. Here, writer has very nicely tried to use the Indianness and also tried to convey how the fake astrologers tried to fool us by just having mere psychology knowledge, or we can say no astrology at all, okay? And also some Indianness, some humor. So I hope you enjoyed the story. Read the full story very nicely, okay? With this, we complete this chapter. I hope you all enjoyed the story. Please read the story once again. Mark and understand the difficult words and their meanings, okay? Take care. Stay safe. Stay home. Thank you, students. Study well.